say that it's a, you can continue the debate until ever, but I think we must get to a point where we can say, listen, this department was responsible for the regulation and the safety regulations regarding the dam. And I think maybe Mr. Walters can assist us in that as well. Thank you.
Thanks, Madam Chair. Chairperson, mine is comment and one question. On my comment, I will say thank you for doing this presentation because it's opening our mind and a lot of questions. And some of the questions doesn't belong to me, which shows that a chair, we've got a lot of work that we need to do in terms of understanding everything that is happening here. My question here is that these dams, who belongs to it? The old Rubani, sir. Where is the owner? Because there is a question also on that person that is owning it. If you call, thanks to you.
Thank you, Chairperson. Chair, sitting here the whole day, having heard what the presenters had to say about what's going on in Jagersfontein, I refuse to hear any argument that seeks to say the department had absolutely no business trying to find out what was going on there. That because of the court order, it was nobody in government's business, as far as minerals is concerned, to one, find out what's going on there, two, to have any regulatory power. The reason why I say so is because hearing the nature of the judgment that was made and hearing how the department practically folded its arms on any contestation of the outcome of the judgment, that for me says that the folding of the arms was deliberate, particularly given the transition in ownership of the rights of the mine. So one, we had De Beers at some point, it was Jagersfontein at some point, it was Superkolong at some point, now it is Starjem. But what remains true and what we all know, but we're not all willing to confirm to be the truth, is that in one way or the other, there has been trading of diamonds that have been discovered at that mine. The court order just happened to be a convenient cloaking cloth altogether to what is happening exactly there, particularly in the Free State, given that the judgment is only true to the borders of this province. So hearing the department argue, I am left with no other conclusion to say that the National Department, given the past leadership when everything happened, the predecessors of the current leadership, and everybody who's been working in the department from then till now, have effectively failed the residents of Jagersfontein and the Free State by allowing the order to hold as is. Because what is true is whether the mining of diamonds or minerals at that mine is happening in a traditional or non-traditional way, bottom line is there are minerals that are extractable, there are minerals that have been sold. Somebody somewhere is chowing the money of those resources. And somebody somewhere is being protected by whatever the department has to say. While, Chair, my biggest then issue remains the fact that the departmental representatives that are here can only answer so many things and can only account for so many things. I also want to beg to say, we cannot reconvene this session without having the politicians responsible in here to answer. because there's more than just the ownership of the mine that we need to ask. There are a whole lot of other issues. But what I want to know from you, me Kalima, is you say you in 2007 it happened, you folded your arms, it was none of your business. But then during the years, there have been community engagements with the department of you guys and the provincial government and the local government. And there were reports of issues there, but you still did nothing. So I'm very much concerned about your comfortability with that standpoint. Perhaps maybe do a bit more justice in explaining, but why could you not? Why did you choose to do so? Whose directive was it to not do anything? Because for sure somebody somewhere in some office said that we must do something, but somebody said you can't do something, so who's that somebody?
Thank you. Actually, Honorable Khakhao said what I wanted to say, but I'm going to say it differently. I cannot grapple with that you said that the mine, that the department had no jurisdiction over the mine. It is good to say, in my home, which is my private home, I can commit any crime and I won't be held liable. The department must have a regulatory power, especially where the safety of a community is at risk. So I would like to know, what does it mean when you say that as a result of the judgment, the department had no regulatory power? There can't be such a thing. I want clarity on that, please.
Thank you, Chairperson. I just want to repeat the question that I asked Mr. Walters, which he said I must refer to you, and that relates to the possibility of the poisons seeping into rivers and streams in Matrabeng, because we don't want a similar disaster there. We know that there is already a lot of sewerage in those rivers and streams, and when you approach that municipality, you can actually smell it from a distance. Now, my concern is that the smell of sewerage is perhaps hiding the smell of poisons that could be there, because we were told that the poisons from gold mining are very different to those of diamond mining. With the acid dry mine drainage, etc. So perhaps you could just tell me whether you're regulating that, whether you've tested there to see whether there's any poison coming out of those mine dumps or out of the mines currently, and whether there's a danger for the community there. And then my second more comment than a question relates to star gems. Chairperson, this province has had experience of companies that come into the Free State, they plunder our resources, our money, and that money ends up in Dubai. Now, a little bit of research has shown me that Star Gems bought both Roypoort Holdings in Kimberley and Jagersfontein Holdings. This company is registered in Dubai. Dubai is one of those places where companies are protected, just like bank accounts are protected in the Cayman Islands and other places. So if we're going to hold someone accountable, and we know that with the Fleda Dairy project, for example, we haven't been able to get the money because a lot of that money is hidden in Dubai-based companies. Now, this company is also registered in Dubai. So my concern is that if we're going to start holding perhaps Star Gems accountable, how are we going to do it if they are registered abroad and in a place specifically where havens are created to protect companies? And that's just a general comment to the committee as well. Thank you, Chair.
Thanks, Momas. On my side, it's more of a comment that when we started, the chair was very upfront that we are just not on a qualifying division, and she set the tone for the meeting. And when we do introduction, once again, we requested that people must properly introduce themselves. Part of why we wanted that is to make sure that relevant people are here. I want to use that chair as a point that will make us to understand why it's always important to have right people, not necessarily that we've got wrong people. There are questions that sometimes will sound as if they are unfair, because there are people that are supposed to be responding to those questions, and where you see that there are some challenges and there are issues to be attended to. Probably as a lesson and part of what I want to take forward in dealing with this issue of Jagersfontein, let's agree that there are things that are not going to be able to be answered in this sitting today. Probably she is correct that we have to have another meeting where we'll have to have all relevant stakeholders in one room, so that we can get to the bottom to some of these things and assist. Because the more we talk about it, is the more we realize. And this issue of the judgment is not only binding for the states, it's binding the entire country, not unless we have something contrary to the country. So currently there's no other judgment contradicting this one. So it's not binding, it's not only binding for the state, it's binding Mpumalanga, it's binding KZN, Northern Cape, all the provinces that we have in South Africa. That is why the decision of not challenging that judgment has made us to be in this current situation today. And the more I want to talk about it, is the more I realize that you will try, my sister, is happening outside, because what is happening outside with those steps? Because there are some serious regulations when you want to do trading. Then you ask the next question, who's assisting those people once they have the time? Mm-hmm. Because we're not confused about the mandate of the department. We're very clear. We understand your core business is to regulate mining in our country. But you have something out of a technicality because somebody has mined that thing and it happened to be outside, and it's no longer that process of getting it underground, and then you want to divorce that process. And the more we want to get to that, then you're going to say, but you can't link what you want to raise with the judgment, because the judgment has made that thing to be separate to something that is coming from the ground. So, Che, I'm of the view that after they've done everything and responded to all the other questions, we still have to have a way of getting all people in one room, because it's not the end of it. That is why she even confirmed in assisting my sister that there's something that happened before the judgment, when we talk about the other help, where we lost people. They've cited another example of some challenges that happened in Free State. But all said and done, I feel that as Parliament, probably we have to make it a rule, because I think it's her next to me when she was, or it's huge being supported by my colleague next to me when he said, no, relax, my sister, we're not attacking you. Then jokingly I said, no, it's angry about what happened there and the people that left that dam and that created the problem. And it's because to sometimes it can be heated, but it will always be good for us to have a minister and fight a minister in front of you. Because I'm asking myself, if we are going to report as a department, are they going to understand what we are subjecting you to? Or we are going to tell them, hey, they tried their best, but to manage them to survive. So we dealt with them. It can't be business as usual, especially after 20 years or 28 years of this democracy. We have to change how we do things. And I'm at a disadvantage because I sympathize with the people coming from a department when the DGs and the politicians are not in. And when they might think, if the minister was here, they are going to say, were happy about the presentation. We are not going to say we are happy when things are wrong. There's no way that we are going to say we are happy. We are going to deal with them the manner we are dealing with you. But even to tomorrow, my last point, tomorrow, Chair, as we'll be going there, probably, if it's possible, to still engage, because we're not doing anything under the carpet. We're not excluding any person in those meetings who are happy. So for the people that are relevant to be in, because they can get a slot and clarify. If you, it's worse now with the technology, the more you go to what they're presenting, you realize that we have to have them at some stage to clarify us. Thanks, Chair.
Papa has said a lot. What I was going to say was exactly what Papa just said. No more, we need no honor for someone again. Because really, I understand with the department, like Papa was saying, the two new anyway, go and do this presentation, nothing else. So now, we want you to ease the conscience of what you have done, what you were told to do to us. Like Papa was saying, we need those stakeholders, inclusive with the minister itself. All the stakeholders, we need them here. And tell us really what's going on. Because I don't hear, guys, I'm concerned about communities. I don't hear a thing whether are there any shelters, our communities are there, and then how are they going to be compensated? You only read papers. Kono 20 million abaphumi. You don't know what was Maphuma api. Most of what I'm looking for 20 million for unqaphezela labo abazokuzwisisa. And to ensure that those beneficiaries that are there are going to gain maybe from all these things. I think that really we are just hitting our head on the wall. We won't get anything what we came here for. It's a matter of for us to go back. It's a select committee, it's OP, not a parliament.
Thank you, Mama. The day before the incident happened, the general manager was slamming on top of the wall. Why he didn't, because he saw that the disaster would happen. Why he didn't call the risk management and make sure that this disaster not happen? Or maybe just alert the surrounding people to say, I see these things, it's very dangerous, the danger is coming, let's move away from this. Because immediately when he was on top of that, the wall, the police came, they passing there, Then they met this, spoke whatever they said. People had lost their life. And according to the department, no, there's nothing for diamond, the diamonds. What a really activity that is happening there. Why the international people are coming there? And if they're okay, like Honorable Nyambi was saying, if they induce them dump the minerals and then people can take them, clean them and take them. So the department, there's nothing that they can do because it's a dumping site. Surface, but the minerals are taken to international for that matter. who's escorting them from the site? They are taken. Oh, okay. Maybe they are taken according to the minerals to put them where they're supposed to go. Until they were supposed to be escorted, because if they can be robbed on the way, because they are minerals. So are you saying that thing? It's fine, nobody escorted them, they are just doing it as a mazama in another way. But again, Honorable Cooper, that side, he's talking about Jagersfontein developers project that are not from the country. They just come here. They just come here in our country to do illegal things, and then they just go back home. And people get, they die. They lost whatever they have, because I wanted to say something, but I don't. I'm not going to go there, because it will be like I'm out of order. But yes, they don't care about the lives of the people. Like I said, it is not an accident. The owners or that Jagersfontein developers project owners, they knew about that dam is not safe, or the dumping surface that are not safe at all. And they've been telling the department, they've been telling everybody that we are not safe, but nobody stood with them. Nobody said anything about them. Say, no, it's okay. It's fine. Let's continue to do whatever we wanted to do. It's fine. It's a pity, because we are raising these issues to you and your team. But really, we become emotional. We become emotional, especially us as the select committee, because for us to be in the select committee or in the National Council of Provinces, we are there to represent the interest of the community. Our provinces, we are not like other portfolio committee in national. They are there at the national level. They don't have constituents. They are floating. Tina, we are there to represent our communities. But when we are there every day, they see us on the television talking big English, but down there, they are dying. Down there, Department of Environment, when they presented, they say no, they are still waiting to hear whether the chronic illness will, after the test and so on, will be there. Of course, when the chemical is happening, I mean, it's spilled in the lives of the people, at the end of the day, they are going to suffer. They are going to suffer the rest of their life. Not only the people who are traumatized, but those who are affected by chemicals, they are going to suffer for the rest of their life. If that's why we are saying we become emotional. The reason why I said we must stop, I was seeing that really, really, really something to explain to us, no, we are responsible for only minerals that are coming down deep from under the earth. Nothing else. But I want to tell me that Honorable Member Jane, he said those people are from Dubai. Are you saying they came from Dubai and come here and operate without license? Are you saying that, ma'am? They are operating without license. They are taking minerals here. Whether they are taking them in the dam or in the surface dam, but they are taking minerals. I think I would say respond, Honorable Mem and your team. But we need the principal. We need the principal of all the departments. Department of Water and Sanitation, Labor Department, the key department, the village, previously was saying about social development. No, those are not important, that one. We can handle them later, but the sooner the better, Honorable Nyambi, we get these three departments, Mineral Resources and Energy, Environment, Labor, and including law enforcement to tell us whether did they escort people who are digging, or if they are not digging, who are taking the mineral, because they are not digging again according to the department. Or is it the law for the minerals to be taken without any security following them? You can respond to them, and then we'll call the department as soon as yesterday. Thanks, ma'am. Not yourself only, with your team.
Thank you, Chair. Under normal circumstances, when the department is involved, which unfortunately is not the case here, when we issue a license, we will issue it in the name of whoever we have applied. And then we will know exactly who the owner of the license is, because the license, when we issue it, it becomes a contract between the department and that company. Because remember, it does not stop at the issuing stage. We have to conduct audits. We have to monitor the operations. So now the contract is to state exactly who the parties to the contract are. The department, and then so we will know exactly who the owner of the mine is. But in this instance, like I said, since the date of the judgment, the department has not been involved, because we had to respect what the court said, otherwise we would be in contempt of court. I know I'm not going to be popular for that, but unfortunately, that is the situation. We have not been involved since the date of the judgment. Regarding the issue of the dam and then all the water-related issues, like I said, if you recall, when I did my presentation, we went to the site on the day of the disaster, and then when we got there, we were told by the company that they are being regulated by the Department of Water Affairs. They have a license that is issued, or that was issued by the Department of Water Affairs, which is still valid. And then Water Affairs officials were also on site, they were there. So I guess they will be in a better position to answer to all the water-related issues, because that is not our mandate. So we will not be in a position. Department of Labor on occupational health and safety issues. So that department is also regulating them on those issues. Last week, on Tuesday, our minister visited the area after the president was there or the previous day. And there was a commitment that was made to assist and a commitment was made by our minister that because what has happened there is similar to what happened in Marysprint, and fortunately Marysprint was under the control of the department, so we will be in a position to offer our expertise, because there was a task team that was set up to investigate what could have led to that disaster. So the department is part of the task team, but the investigation is still ongoing, so we do not know what the outcome of the investigation will be. But there are other stakeholders, it's not just the Department of Mineral Resources. I think the Department of Environmental Affairs mentioned that when they were presenting. So it's the task team is composed of various stakeholders. There's water affairs, I mean there's environmental affairs, there's us, there's other stakeholders as well. And right now the investigations are still undergoing, and at the time that it was formed, no time frames could be given, because there is some work that still needs to be done that will then give an idea of how much time it will take before the investigation can be completed. So I guess that is still the case. So at this stage, there is no commitment on how long the process of the investigation will take until certain studies and certain investigations are undertaken, and then that will then give an idea of when a report with recommendations can then be made. So that is, and then on the issue of the dams in Belcom, what makes it different to what is going on here? In Machabeng, there is active mining taking place. So Harmon is mining actively. So, and we are regulating what is going on there. However, like Honorable, yes, indicated, the issue of the surface dams, especially, at least, like I said, at least on the, in the Free State region, it's binding, that decision is binding on the whole province. So even in the Free State, we do not have jurisdiction to regulate their dams, but all their mining operations are being regulated in terms of NEMA, because they are still actively mining. So there's financial provision for rehabilitation in place. We are monitoring their operations because they have environmental authorizations in respect of each mining operation that they have. They hold various mining operations in and around the Machabeng area. So there is different because we are monitoring it on an ongoing basis, because we are regulating that there's active mining, they're mining. So it's different, but the issue of regulating the dams is also out of our hands because of the court judgment. There was also a question, there was a complaint that was received by, or that was sent to the minister when he was visiting the province on political business. Then the community of Jagersfontein raised concerns to the minister about what is going on there. So we are aware of that. A minister was planning to visit Jagersfontein in August. I remember we were even requested by ministry to write some briefing notes for the minister, but then that visit was postponed because there were other things that the minister needed to attend to, but that complaint was received, and then the minister was supposed to visit the area in August, but it could not happen. there was a question on the issue of the Mary Sprite occurrence that happened in 1994. I guess my colleague from our national office, Mine Health and Safety, will answer that. And if I can, through you, Chair, allow you to take us through what happened there and then the compare the two occurrences. Over to you in that day, Zondi.
Thank you, Honourable Chair, with your permission. I just want to highlight that after the Mary Sprite unfortunate disaster, which had claimed the life of 17 community people, the department in November 2000, we gazetted a guideline for the compilation of a mandatory code of practice on mine residue deposits. And the objective of that guideline was to make sure that mining companies, they design and operate their residue deposits in a safe manner and don't pose a hazard to the neighboring communities. And there was also a question that was raised regarding the trading of diamonds by Jagersfontein Development Company. In South Africa, honorable members, we've got what we call the South African Precious Metals and Diamond Regulator, which is responsible for the trading on any precious metals and diamonds, which also means that even the Jagersfontein Development Company must comply with the requirements of the regulator by obtaining the necessary licenses from the regulator, so that they can be able to trade in diamonds. I think the important going forward is just to make sure that that they have complied with the requirements of the regulator. Otherwise, they'll be in breach of the law. And I've also request my colleague just to indicate on the number of slime stems that are in the Free State. Thank you, Chairperson.
Thanks, honorable members. I just want to indicate the number of slimes in the entire Free State. We have a total of 53 slime dams. And I just want to indicate that some of the slime dams, they are reworking on them, they are processing them so that they cannot have a lot of slime dams. They are processing them so that they must have a one mega slime dam so that we can avoid this type of situation. And there was a comment that was made regarding the tailings dam and tailing dam. Maybe I wanted just to clarify the difference. On the tailing dam, is the operational dam that they are depositing on it. The tailing dam is the one that they are no longer depositing any slime further. But others, my colleagues, they also highlighted that we are doing the monitoring on the authorized mining rights like this one in Jagersfontein.
You are still oh, okay, no, sorry for that.
I wanted to add the Department of Water and Sanitation, now the one that we are talking about, even when we are processing the new application, is the one of the competent authority that we engage in from the day of lodgement. There are a lot of technical matters that needs to be attended to before we issue.
means that the Minister of Water and Sanitation need to concur with our recommendation regarding the issue of environmental authorization. There are a lot of technical reports, including the engineering designs and a lot of matters that need to be looked at by the specialist in DWS before we approve any of any environmental authorization. In addition to the monitoring, because DWS, they are the custodian of water resources, they are monitoring all the mines as far as water-related issues is concerned. And then including they are what we call the monitoring boards. All the slimes that you can see in Belgium and other areas, there are a lot of monitoring holes that they are checking the water quality surrounding the slime dams. And then this one is also going to the safety. It means that in the inspection, there are three role players that are conducting inspections surrounding the slime dams. Environmental people in the DMRE site. There's an official from water and sanitation, and then there are mines and safety inspectorate, which is in our office in Free State. Thanks.
Chairperson, the mine which is in our office in the Free State that's responsible for the safety, because the only report we have currently that is can be backed up is the 2020-2021 report. So where is yours? What does it say? Because I can, it doesn't fall within the same couple because of the court order, you also couldn't do anything about the inspection of safety.
Can I respond to that? Is that we've got the MPRDA and Management Safety Act, and the two acts are linked, right? The MPRDA empowers the Management Safety Act for us to conduct audits and inspection at a mine, right? Now, since Jagersfontein was declared not to fall under the jurisdiction of the MPRDA, that is also applicable to the Management Safety Act, right? But honourable members, that does not create a policy or legislative gap, because we still have the Occupational Health and Safety Act, which falls under the Department of Employment and Labour. So there's no gap in terms of monitoring of operations similar to Jagersfontein and others in the country. So both Department of Employment and Labour, they need to monitor such a operation or plans.
So just to be clear, is the department, am I correct in understanding that you are saying that the human beings who should be held accountable regarding what happened at Jagersfontein, there's a train of them, but included in that train is one, the Department of Water and Sanitation, and two, the Department of Labor. Is that what I'm hearing from you? Forget about the provincial government, the local government, the whole lot. The two departments, are you saying those are the departments that should account for why there's nothing else what was done?
I'm raising this question now, but I think between you and the Department of Environment, anyone or both of you might have an answer. I just read an article that said that Stargell Group says they take responsibility and they will I do understand, you know, the whole thing about the jurisdiction of of mining. But they also said, there's another article that said that water and sanitation said there was a, or whoever said that, because the mine was, or the, was sold to Star James a few, you know, not long ago. And then it said there was a full due diligence conducted prior to the acquisition, whether that was not done by the previous owner, the now owner, what apartment, whatever, we don't know. I would like to know the investigation or the what the Department of Environmental Affairs found and the samples that are sent in, and said there will be an investigation. The alleged things that's been in the papers saying that the local municipality warned at one stage about the dam that it was unsafe, and then it was about 2 years ago, and then it was pulled back, and you know, a lot of things. And then the portfolio committee that was here from Friday on also said they got reports that 4 hours before the dam, the wall broke, they were informed. All those things are there. Will the department or the departments, those who are here, we will have to ask water and sanitation separately because they're not here. If that private investigation is going to be done, does any department going to lay charges or to start a criminal investigation or not? And in the end, if you're going, if not, why not? And if so, yes. Because we can sit here for 700 days and asking the same questions over and over and over. If there's not going to be any investigation apart from our oversight role, we will have to wait to get the real information from the investigation that's going to be conducted, whether it's going to be criminal or private. And then for us then, as members of parliament and the committee, we will have to then start focusing on what is the way forward, what is our responsibility to help either by legislation or regulation or whatever, to make sure that the risk of tailing dams are being addressed either through legislation or what kind of thing, and make sure that these things are not how it's going to happen in the future. And I think the other responsibility specifically for the Free State legislature is the role that has to be played by all role players to make sure that that community that has been destroyed by this disaster is being looked after and cared after, and that the infrastructure and everything that we've heard here is being destroyed, as has to be rebuilt or rehabilitated, or in a way make the life of people normalize it in a way. Thank you.
No, and call
are with, because the environment has said their own things that didn't happen. They were on the ground, you are on the ground, though you are not responsible for those things. And I think the last time I saw Honorable Nyambi, the article says the Deputy Minister Mahlo laid a charge against the owner and so on. So really, we will be doing injustice to you, to the team. This thing, when the questions are raised, we can see where we need those departments. They can give us more answers. So I'll request the members that immediately after the department, not only one department responded, we will share the response with you. I'm not undermining you, ma'am. You did your best with your team. You did your best. Can you put it right? Maybe you will be able to get there and then act and so on and so on to give us the answers.
Are there any time frames?
Oh, yes. Yes, members, because it's agent, oh, I don't want to take my when can department give us the answers? Next week. Today or 7 days.
Change.
department. Indeed, when things happen, we are not supposed to point finger to one another. We must help each other. For us to ask a lot of questions, it was not because we wanted to put to point and say, you are wrong, wrong department, you did this and this. No, we want to help each other so that at the end of the day, the community that we are representing, they must get services, they must get good health, they must get clean water, and then they must get shelter. That's why we are so curious to ask a lot of questions as a member of parliament, because even ourselves, when we go there to the communities, yes, they are dating us. Last week they would say, no, the members of parliament, they're not doing anything, they're just throwing money. Tina here down the ground, we are suffering, and they don't even care about us. So when you come from the meetings, community meetings, that's where we come with a full of questions in our head, and then say, department, you are the implementer. Please give us the tangible answers so that we can go back to the community and respond to them. It's not about we are undermining the department or the officials, but we want to help each other. In our language, we say, Pediatie, e koma ke go tshwara gane. Together with you, we can make a lot. When I'm alone, there are things that I cannot do. But when we are together, we can do a lot of things. And things can happen when we are together. That's why when I opened the meeting, I said, there's no any political party that this year. All of us, we are the member of parliament. We are doing oversight over the department as it is our mandate. That is entrenched from the constitution that the parliament will do the oversight over the department. So, by so saying, honorable members, I would like to thank everybody, the officials from legislature. And then, hey, we thank for the lunch. Hey, we receive lunch, we receive water, we receive breakfast and everything. Oh, first aid, you are the number one. So thank you very much, the officials. If it was not about you, we didn't get those things. But because you work immediately when we heard that we are coming, some of you, you didn't even have time to be with your family. You were running around to make sure that we get the place, to make sure that we get those food and water and everything. Thank you very much. And department, for you to travel, I know there are things that you're supposed to be doing today, but you said no, let's go there to the select committee, answer the questions and give them the clarity, what our mandate is as the department, so on. Thank you very much. From time to time, we will call you, and please don't be afraid to come and say, hey, those members are going to ask irrelevant questions because we all, like I said, sometimes I said we are a lay person, we ask the questions so that at the end of the day we must be able to respond to our community. We are not doing deal with these issues of the minerals, not an easy thing on daily basis, but because you guys know very well. No, thank you very much. We are still going to meet the department, the D department, very soon, maybe by next week. I'll hear from the WIPs what day they can allow us to have this meeting as soon as possible. So that when you go to another province, because the department, the national department, we are going to do oversight. We are not going to, because 2 years we have been sitting in the offices because of COVID. Now we are going outside to see when the department are saying, oh, we did this and this, and when the community are complaining, whether you are able to, to give what they want. So we are going to do oversight. From here, this is the first province. We are still going to go to other provinces, and we have 9 provinces. And then we are going to go. The Department of Environment, Department of Mineral Resource and Energy, Department of Land Affairs, we are going down to the community to hear and to come with the resources. Because when you go there, we want you to be there so that you can give them the answers. Not only answers, but do what they need, if possible. Because sometimes, when we are the community members, we can ask something that is not possible. And I like the department when things are beyond their control. They must say it. They must not promise, because to promise is very dangerous. That's why sometimes the community are fighting over things, because if we see that the community are angry, we just give them the promises, and empty promises is dangerous. So thank you.